put people in their proper position. Reclaim the kingdom as a kingdom of theocracy as opposed to monarchy. He began to reintroduce the God of history back into the nation that he had called out, Judah, this place called praise. And so now we have this situation in which now God is brought back into the center of the life of the children of Israel. The writer says that the transformation of the culture was like nothing ever seen before since David was king some 300 years earlier. Now, do you believe for a moment that the adversary of your soul is going to allow that kind of revival to take place without rearing up his ugly head? Do we believe for a moment that once you begin to put down those things that have inhibited you from serving God in fullness and in faith, that the devil is going to just sit by and allow you to get filled with the Holy Ghost and serve God in spirit and in truth? We must realize that once he had us, he always wants us. And you ought not be surprised that when you try to do good, evil will always be present. When you try to go down the pathway called right, wrong is going to show up. And every time you think you let something go that was hindering you, another obstacle is going to show up in your way. You ought not be surprised if the host of hell and the hellhounds don't show up when you're trying to get your praise on. You ought not be surprised that the demons and the imps won't show up to trip you on your way to church. You ought not be surprised that when you begin to put God back at the center of your life, there will be some things and some people who will try to take you off course, because God has a plan for your life that the devil don't want. And said, you know, I tried. I've done all the right things, Christina. I've tried to serve him to the fullness, D.D. I've given my life to him, but it seems like hell keeps knocking on my door. I've done what I was supposed to do, and now I'm under siege. I need to realize that if I go to God, that God will try to affirm for me that he is for me. And so therefore I need to understand that there are some things that I must do before God will fight my battle. Don't get twisted. You just can't sit on the blessed assurance and expect God to fight your battle. There's some things that we must do first. There's some things that we must contribute to the fight. I'm not saying that you got to keep your fisticuffs going on, but there are some things that we must contribute before God will break forth and break in. He's there, but he wants to make sure that we've laid the right groundwork to realize that God is the one that's going to fight the fight. That God is well able at any stage to jump in and fight the fight. But if God is going to inform us and infuse us, he wants us to know that we're supposed to operate with him and not just watch him work. I wish I had someone here who would testify that when I stopped watching and I started participating, when I stopped being a spectator, I started being a participant, when I stopped listening to the whole prayer, and started praying for myself, when I stopped watching people pray, defeated. You know why you're defeated? Because you got some attitudes that need to be defeated. you really want to do battle with the enemy, you need to have the proper preparation. You need to have the proper fortification. You need to have the proper motivation. And then you need to put all that together, get on your knees, and have the proper consecration. Because after a while and by, when you put yourself in front of God, God will give you confirmation. The Bible says in the 21st verse, the Lord said an angel would cut off all the mighty men of valor and the leaders and the captains in the camp of the king of Assyria. So he returned with shame of his face to his own land. I want you to know that the children of Israel never cast an arrow. The children of Israel never picked up a spear. The children of Israel never loaded a gun. The children of Israel never got a bow. They just got consecrated. They got fortified. They were motivated. They were prepared. And God showed up. And God fought the battle. Is there anybody here who can testify? I need God to show up. I need God on my side. I need God to let the wind your adversaries, you can't see those who are trying to hurt you. God will go before you. God will stay behind you. God will keep you covered. God will be your foundation. He'll be on the left. He'll be on the right. God is able to find your battle. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, I don't know about you. Nuts in his head.